r/AskReddit. Cops of Reddit, what famous people have you pulled over and how did it go down? My dad pulled over Clint Eastwood. I guess this was just after they started requiring licenses to drive motorcycles in California. He pulled him over because he was driving squirrely, like he didn't really know how to ride. His was response to license issue was, "Man, next thing you know you'll need a license to ride a horse." Former police cadet and dispatcher here. I was on a ride along and was told this story. So this officer pulls this car over for speeding. She then suspects the driver of being drunk. She calls in his driver's license to run it. The dispatcher tells her, "You have Nick Nolte pulled over? Do you know who he is? He's a movie star." The officer is young and doesn't know who Nick Nolte is. Turns out he wasn't drunk. He was just being Nick Nolte. She gave him a warning and sent him on his way. My co-worker wrote Wes Craven a ticket. He didn't know who he was, and so when he gave him the ticket, he just was like, "Here's your ticket, Mr. Craven." My co-worker told me that if he knew he wrote a ticket to the Nightmare on Elm Street guy, he would have issued a warning instead. My co-worker is also from Kosovo, so when he tells it with his accent it's extra funny. My friend's dad arrested 6x99. I'm not a cop. But when I was in school, one of the school cops was watching our class for a little while. And he decided to tell us about some chick he arrested a few nights earlier. He arrested some lady for drunk driving. And she kept screaming at him to look her up and that she's famous. He looked up her name. And it turns out she was on The Voice. He watched the video on YouTube of her singing terribly and being an ass to the judges. He arrested her and found out she was wanted in Louisiana, so he had her sent all the way from San Angelo, Texas to bumfuck nowhere, Louisiana. Moral of the story. Shut up. You're not famous. I wasn't a patrol officer, but rather the sheriff's deputy at Aspen's airport. Sardi Field. I had to threaten to tow both Kurt Russell's and Hunter Thompson's vehicles more than once when they left them where they weren't supposed to. Parked right in front of the airport. Hunter was Hunter and just mumbled and groused. And Kurt usually just waved and smiled. Dirty violators. The both of them. I can still remember Russell's license plate. VCD 711. My dad was a cop. Pulled over none other than Marilyn Manson for an unsafe signal lane change. He was bragging the day it happened, in the early 2000s. Said he was nondescript and low-key. Apologetic and didn't act like a big shot above the law. So, from the comments here we can conclude that not many police officers use Reddit. My father-in-law was a police officer for many years and often regales the story of how, during a routine traffic stop, he met the great Kit Duncan. D'Angelo Russell. He was respectful and didn't mention who he was. I didn't know it was him till I recognized his name and looked him up. I let him go with a warning on some chicken shit window tint traffic stop. When I was a cop, I pulled Blake Shelton over once. I walked up the window, went through my little spiel, "Hello, my name is Officer Joskvin with the city police. The reason I've stopped you tonight is insert crime. May I see your license and insurance verification?" He gives me his stuff and it's really late, so I haven't even figured out it's him yet. I'm just thinking this guy looks familiar. He was really friendly and pretty apologetic, super nice guy. I wanted to ask for an autograph, a picture, but felt like it would have been unprofessional. My father was a police officer for 27 years and in one day he pulled over Paul Newman, who apparently was notorious for speeding. So my dad goes to cite him and gets a call for an accident that needed assistance down the road. Then sometime shortly thereafter, my father pulled him over again and Newman allegedly groaned, "Not you again." Of course I'm not a police officer, but NASCAR driver Kurt Busch was pulled over once. He tried the "don't you know who I am" routine. It didn't work. For what it's worth, he's a lot less stuck up nowadays. Once a member of parliament were detained and put to jail for being too wasted. After an hour this MP told me that she wants to get out, but I refused since she was still too drunk. Then MP said to me, "Don't you know who I am?" and I answered, "Yes. But don't you know as a lawmaker that it applies to everyone?" and slammed MP's cell door. She got pretty pissed but surprisingly didn't file any complaints against me. Typos. I gave the long-haired guy, early 2000s I believe, from Hootie and the Blowfish a ticket for no leash on his dog. We were driving on a small beach island and he's standing on a side road with his dog and no leash. He told my partner and I he was in a band and we asked which band he was in and he told us. We both were like, we've never heard of this band, lying. I said, Hootie? Good luck with that, is it rap? And he laughed and said no. He was cool. Still gave him the ticket. Not exactly what you're looking for, but relatable. My father was a repo man for a short time in Newark, NJ. He ended up getting a call to put a car on the hook for unpaid bills. As he put the car on the hook, a man started running out to the street shouting, "Hey man, that's my car. Don't you know who I am?" My father had no idea. The man then proceeded to tell my father that he's red man. My father responded, "Yeah? Well, I'm white man. Next time pay your bill." And drove off with the car. My dad ran into Bo Jackson emerging from a patch of woods in camouflage carrying a bow, possibly poaching, trespassing, right outside his gated community in the woods. Burridge, Illinois. They just chatted about the large local buck. They both apparently knew of. For a few minutes and parted ways. Personally, also cop. I never dealt with anyone famous. Unless you count the kids of the Chicago Bears radio broadcaster. Jeff Joniak. Former police officer here. I was on patrol when I saw a group of people trying to cross the street on a very busy and dangerous four-lane highway in the dark. I pulled over and loaded them up and drove them across. It was the band, Till Tuesday. Nice people. Cop here. We wouldn't really be able to tell you any stories. At least in the UK. Due to data protection. Not a police officer and not famous, but I was so high once that I drove by a cop standing by his car. He waved to me and I pulled myself over thinking he was flagging me down. I have the same name as someone famous. When I get pulled over by the cops, it doesn't help me any. The fact I look nothing like them and live in a different county doesn't help. Kind of similar. My dad had a seizure and one of the fire department guys was a retired NASCAR truck series driver. Dude was chill as hell and told some stories for me and my siblings to calm us down. Not a police officer. But I was a Nick Park ranger in Central Park. I asked Christiane Amanpour from CNN to put her dog on a leash and she said, "Do you know who I am?" I said, "I don't care who you are. Put your dog on a leash." My dad is a retired NYPD cop. Many years ago he pulls over a limo in Brooklyn speeding on highway zooming towards Manhattan. Driver pulls over and admits to speeding and begs my dad not to look in back. He naturally looks in back and there is Johnny Mathis and another guy stark naked going at it. Johnny Mathis begs him not to say anything and my dad says no prob. When he returns to precinct, there is an envelope there for him. Two front row tickets to see him perform at the old Rainbow Room in Rockefeller Center. He goes with his fiancée. Now my mom, and I was born 9 months later. Thanks, Johnny. If it wasn't for him, I might not even be here. Only local politicians. They've all been assholes and expected me to just let them go regardless of why I stopped them. Some got warnings. Some got tickets. One got arrested because she was drunk. I treated them just like I treat everyone else. Some of my co-workers got pissed about the arrest because she was on the county council and they vote on our pay raises. But DUI is DUI. I'd rather piss off a council member and miss out on a raise than let some drunk go and find out later they hit and killed someone. I pulled over Selena Gomez doing 80 in a 30 mph zone. She said she'd do anything to not get a ticket. I said anything? And when she confirmed, I got to suck her dick. My dad pulled over Milwaukee Bucks player Ersanai Lazova. He was going well over the limit and well over the pace that traffic was following. My dad was going to cut him a break until he blurted out in his Turkish accent, "I was just keeping up with traffic." Slapped a ticket on his ass for trying to argue over a petty ticket that wouldn't even make a dent in his 7 mil a year contract. I read this somewhere once. So it must be true. A cop pulls a guy over for speeding and asks him, "Who do you think you are? Nigel Mansell?" It was a while ago. The guy looks puzzled and says, "No. I'm Ayrton Senna." When you're rich, a ticket isn't a penalty for bad behavior. It's an admission ticket for the right to do it all you want. Sam Elliott has a ranch just outside of Brownsville. Or, which is just off to the left of nowhere. A buddy of mine is a deputy for the county. And has run into him in the store buying milk or whatever. One of my buddy's co-workers had to go out to the ranch to take a report. When Mrs. Elliott got bit by a dog or something. The next day, my friend pulled them over without realizing who it was initially until he ran the plate. When he went up, he greeted them and asked how she was doing. And she was all, "Oh, that's so nice of you to ask. Everybody always wants to talk to my husband. Like he's some movie star or something." I guess she wrote a letter to the sheriff about how thoughtful it was of him to ask and what a nice young man he was. It. No cops and no celebrities. Not a cop. But I have seen a CSI Miami preview once. I hope to see some real responses here. Interesting question. Not a cop, but I was working as a lifeguard and we had the beach red flagged, no swimming, for rough surf. There was this girl swimming, so I hopped on my ATV and headed down to call her out of the water. Her swimming was weird. I couldn't put my finger on it right away. Part of determining whether or not I have to rescue someone is to evaluate their swimming stroke. She wasn't in obvious distress. Just swimming around in her weird sort of way. I blow my whistle to get her attention and she starts swimming back to shore. At this point I should probably mention that we had a surf contest going on and there were a bunch of pro surfers in town because of it. She walks out the water and at this point I realize why her swim stroke was weird. She only has one arm. Now I've got to tell Bethany Hamilton that the water is too rough for swimming. I came here to lurk. But the more I realize, I don't know any of these celebrities. My friend is a cop in Chicago and years ago he pulled over Sean Hayes for speeding on Lakeshore Drive. My friend recognized him from TV but didn't let anything on. As he was writing him a ticket, Hayes asked, "Do you watch Will and Grace?" But my friend just said, "Nope. Here's your ticket." This is from Lewis Hamilton in his interview in Letterman. He drove a particularly loud sports car in London. And was promptly pulled over by a cop that told him as he approached Lewis's window, "Who do you think you are? Lewis Hamilton?" He didn't get a ticket. My driving instructor was a former Missouri traffic cop. He told me a story about pulling over Tom Selleck while he was in town filming an episode of Magnum Pie. He wasn't rude. He just thought he could get away with it because he's Tom Selleck. Unfortunately, the cop pulling him over was the infamous Officer Ziegler. My dad once pulled over Bobby Bones for a taillight down Highway 37. Not sure what all went down Beffa, but I do remember my dad quoting him. "Not again." Apparently it had happened at least 4-5 times before this happened and he needed to take that car to go get the replacement bulb. He hadn't noticed until after the morning. Not too interesting, but it's funny to think he was pulled over so many times for the same thing. My father-in-law ended up pulling over a terrorist who was on the FBI's 10 most wanted for expired tags. When he ran the plate and the database, he got a call from an unknown number telling him to keep the guy where he is until backup arrived within 20 minutes. Two FBI agents, SWAT and a Black Hawk helicopter arrived and arrested the guy. Where is Justin Bieber in this thread? Not a cop, but when I was in my teens in about 1992, I took a night college course with an armed response officer. He told me loads of stories about celebs, but one in particular about George Michael. The officer had found two empty cars in a motorway lay-by and as he investigated, two men came out of the brush after an obvious sexual encounter. The officer advised them not to leave their cars unattended. George's was an expensive Range Rover. And left them be. This was about 5 years before George actually came out. As the officer and I are both from George's hometown, he had kept the secret and not told anyone until then. We'd been discussing George's music and were both fans. I've read like 20 comments and don't know any of these dudes. Get ready for a lot of fake stories. Not a police officer, but I've never pulled over a famous person. Not a police officer. Was a corrections officer for a bit. Jason Mewes, Jay and Silent Bob, was a return customer at the jail for quite a bit of time. It's weird. grew up watching those movies and then you just see him inside a housing unit. It's just a really weird feeling. Very nice man. Sad but nice. He struggled for a while and I'm glad he's kept on the straight and narrow. The new Jay and Silent Bob movie scares me because I hope he doesn't do anything reckless now that he has a disposable income. Surprised I don't see anything about Fluffy on here. Not pulled over. But my dad had to block off roads and direct traffic because Bear Grylls was filming there. He was happy to meet him and all but stopped watching the show after they met after he saw firsthand how fake the show really was. Also, Norman Reedus was driving through our town as a pit stop to get to TWD set. And a good friend of my dad's was on duty at the time. Sitting in a spot to patrol, Norman Reedus pulled up beside him and asked, "What's a good place to eat around here?" And my dad's friend escorted him to a popular eating spot in town and got to eat with him. Lol. My dad's a DC cop and pulled over Michelle Obama. It's interesting in these celebrity related posts. Normally everyone says not a celeb or gives a non-personal story. It's interesting interactions with celebrities seem to be this rare. Serious tag. Brings about serious answers. As all things should be. This thread is a bunch of fucking lies. I've never pulled over anyone famous. I've worked off duty jobs for several TV shows. Photo shoots. Etc. Most of the people I've worked with have been great. My dad shouted at Prince Harry once for trying to pet his German Shepherd police dog. Honestly. I applaud your dad. I think it's terrible when we hold our celebrities to lower standards than everyone else. Being funny in a movie has nothing to do with whether you deserve a traffic ticket. I gave Werner Herzog a speeding ticket in the Hollywood Hills in the early 2010s. He was very polite and even shook my hand. Nice fellow. I pulled over Richard Dreyfuss back in 1979. He was pretty resistant, so I had to reluctantly bash him up a little. It was on this day that I realized what heavy drugs can do to a man. Considering the fact that I was a 27-year-old supermarket worker from England and the year was actually 2016. To this day I wonder who the hell I pulled over. And how? I don't drive. My dad was a cop. He pulled over Clayton Moore once. He was a nice guy. My dad pulled over Anthony Kiedis and Flea of the Red Hot Chili Peppers out in the California desert once. They had some girls with them. God only knows what they were doing or where they were going. His partner was actually the one to pull them over. But by chance, he got a glimpse of them. He ran up, confirmed it was them, had a laugh, and convinced his partner to let them go, I think. I was only a kid when I heard this story. Not a cop. Exact opposite, in fact. I was in jail with Cut Calhoun of Strange Music, Tekken 9's label, in a small Oregon coastal city. He had warrants from somewhere back east that were years old apparently. Heard from the cop that arrested him that he couldn't have cared less who it was until his brother found out. And was stupid bummed he didn't get an autograph. Uncle is a cop. Pulled over Justin Bieber twice. Can't remember what for. Probably speeding. But it was a long time ago. The second time he recognized my uncle, lol. I don't know if this really counts, but I'm gonna say it. Back in the late 80s my dad, not a police officer, told me how he heard one of my favorite singers, Michael Jackson, got pulled over once. He told me that's how his lesser known song Speed Demon came around. Legit blew my mind away. I listen to that song day in and day out now. I hoped I'd recognize some of the famous people in this thread but grew more disappointed as I continued down, lol. Not a cop. But still a pretty cool story. When I was about 16 my family took a trip to Canada. We were flying out of San Francisco Airport in the evening and my dad thought it would be cool to head there really early in the morning and spend the day sightseeing first. Given that I was in my I don't give a shit I'll do what I want phase I wore an all black tracksuit. I saw Joel Madden wear one and thought hey that will look good on me. Our last thing we were going to do in SF was a 5-star fancy, and I'm talking suit and tie and gown kinda place. We were sitting at our table. Me thoroughly embarrassed by my fashion choice and feeling like a weirdo in my tracksuit when someone walking by accidentally brushed my shoulder. He turned and said, "Oh, sorry about that." My dad dismissively said, "It's alright, man." I looked up to speak as well and realized it was Travis fucking Barker. I literally died inside and was too starstruck to speak, so I quietly and dumbly went back to my food. To the people responding with a story saying, "Not a cop, damn it, stop." I can't find legit cop responses. Ron Jaworski thought he was DUI, but he was just lost. I shared with him that he was the reason I started watching American football. He was a quarterback for the Eagles. He was touched and gracious. Rey Mysterio, WWE wrestler. He brought some weed through the airport. He was embarrassed and cooperative. Ron Duchendorf, John Denver's brother, very nice and humble. Flavor Flav, super nice. I used to live in Bergenfield, New Jersey a few years back, and I think Chris Rock lives there. Or Inglewood, somewhere in Bergen County. My buddy was a teenage cop and said he pulled him over for going 55 in a 30, and NJ is mad strict with driving. He said Chris was awesome and even gave him an autograph after the speeding ticket. Some police officer pulled over Kit Harington once for speeding or something. He said he'd let him go if he told him if he's really dead in Game of Thrones. He told him. He let him go. True story. At least according to Kit. I once saw a cop pull over Chuck Norris, as he was in a good mood. Chuck Norris let the cop off with a warning. Thanks for watching, mate. Make sure to smash that star button for more high quality content.